I'll be speaking on methods of elevation and the articular reduction. The basic emphasis is on the elevation of the depressed fragments. And the I feel the biggest pleasure in orthopedic theater is restoring the articular congruity in a difficult, complex articular fracture. We have noticed various depressed articular fragment patterns, and they take these various patterns. In the septal depression, I would find them into these four categories. Sort of a pit depression where it goes into a sort of a gadda appearance or a pit, or a collapsing roof where the whole roof of the lateral condyle collapses, or into a boat which appears like a sinking boat and a free floating either aligned or a topsy-turvy fragment. And then we'll have the, so this is a pit depression sort. This is a central complete depression. This is like a collapsing roof. The whole roof of this condyle has collapsed. The outer margin is intact. Then we may have a sort of a sinking boat appearance where this has collapsed and this part rises up into the joint. So it has lost its attachment here. Then a free floating fragment, which could be either topsy-turvy. Then there is a depressed fragment with splaying of metaphysis. This is a quite common variety. And in this type, many times the lateral meniscus may be found entrapped. At times we find this typical variety where there is a locked lateral condyle. If you try to do reduction, it doesn't come. We have to manipulate this fragment back into position by a dura elevator. And we may have a complete depressed fragment completely, or we may have complex depression. So these are the various patterns which we find. And these are the various images, like a collapsing roof. So this, you will find various patterns which keep on happening into the articular surfaces of this complex articular surface depressions. And many times we have a complex depression. So our aim is to get the articular surface back into position. And this one picture I like to emphasize quite often. So this is lateral tibial condyle. This is the eburnated part of the medial condyle. So how do we see on a lateral SIAM image? So we see a lateral condyle and we see a medial condyle. So medial condyle is more proud. So we can judge where which part we are managing. And if you put a dura elevator in the intercondylar eminence area, this is the intercondylar eminence area. And if we put, this is on the lateral condyle. And if you reverse the dura elevator, it would be onto the medial condyle, the concave part. The tibial plateau view, when we get the articular reduction back, this image is really important, as told by Tillman and Moore. So we get 90 degree view as well as 115 degree view. What difference does it make? So this is the view where it is 90 degree, and this is the view which is tilted view. So in this we get the real articular view, and you can find this sharp subchondral bone. So pay attention to this image, and this is what. Here the depression appears only 6 mm as per his paper, and here, and which I also found true, here it appears 12 mm. So judge your depressions in these two views. Study of depressed fragment is important for realignment, and the scanning helps tremendously. All these scanning images, we should look at them. The key to management of this depressed fragment is have a proper assessment. Take a traction view. So when we take on a SIAM, we take a traction X-ray on AP and lateral. Then we apply distractor force, elevate the depression, and then with fixation of those fragments in situ with raft screws or whatever means, and then buttress and graft, or at times graft substitutes, or even without graft, depending on the situation. So imagine various punches required for various fractures. So this appeared quite innocuous on a routine X-ray, but the imaging really gave the various types of pattern of fragment depressions here, what we need to elevate and what we need to buttress. So these are the various things which should be available in our armamentarium. And I like to emphasize on various angles of these punches, small and large punch. There are various indications where to use them. And then we keep it elevated and then lock them into position. So imagine the punch for this. So here you need, you can't elevate this from the lateral side. You will have to go medially. This needs an elevation punch from more posteriorly placed window. So you cannot elevate it by this window. So we need to imagine our punches appropriately. This is the fracture where elevation of sort of roof collapse of this complete condyle would be elevated very nicely, and your punching force has to be here. This requires imaginative elevation, because here the fragment is a very small fragment. So either if you directly look into the joint, or you compress the joint, then get back fragment into position. Many times elevating with a punch and disc of bone is quite useful, especially with multi-fragmented depressed fragments. So this is the window which I would like to plan on the medial surface for elevation of the lateral articular depression, and then the punch is inserted of various angle. This is where we would make a window. The window and the punch takes along with it some amount of articular bone, or we can take out the bone also. So this is the window which would make, and imagine the punch for this. Here you will have to put your punch and a large punch from this side so that it comes to the position. Many times if we have difficulty, this exercise in theater makes it really very important. So you can find out how the punch goes and various patterns and the various positions of punch. If you do this exercise, we can exactly know which is the posterior border, which is the anterior border, according to the densities, and we can put our eye focused onto these images. Now, this requires a punch from the lateral aspect. You can't elevate it from a medial inserted punch. So this fragment would go up with the lateral inserted punch, as you can see here. So here I would introduce a K wire, and with the K wire, I would joystick it into back position. The exact area to be punched is given by this section so that we can exactly elevate the depressed fragment. This one, a whole condylar roof collapse sort of picture, is the easiest to elevate. And I usually would advise a cine effect. So look at this image. If you can have this cine image on Siam, and this can be done by setting the Siam to 16 frames per second setting, where we can get this cine effect. So exactly we get how much amount of elevation needs to be done. This is completely restored, and then the void can be reduced by compressing the fragment by whatever means, and then fixing it appropriately. That would give a optimum articular subchondral surface and reduction. This is a sort of a sinking boat. Here, if you just punch, it tries to jump up into the joint. So we lock it with the K wire and then elevate with a punch appropriately. With multiple fragments, it is easier. So here you will have to judge by the densities. In these situations, many times a submeniscal orthotomy is the best. If there are multiple fragments, then we can align it better. When we use a punch to reduce the width, condylar width, which is increased, what happens? This tries to bury in this soft lateral condyle. The medial usually is tough. So for that, either you use a collinear clamp, or we use a plate clamp or a washer assisted clamp so that it can put pressure onto the condyle to reduce the width. This is a lateral fine tuning for small fragment elevation. So if this is found depressed, we can find it out in a good Siam picture. Then you lock it into position once it is elevated. And the elevation sequence, if you take into a cine effect, then it exactly gives, now it has come appropriately and you are exactly below it. And then you lock it with a K wire in that position. When fixing, this would require a raft position of screw just beneath this. Then only this would not settle down in the subsequent healing process. And then this also I found quite interesting in a depressed lateral condyle. When we elevate and fix with a plate, if plate is bit completely nicely positioned, that would provide a good sustentaculum effect. And a screw from the opposite side, if it is supporting that elevation, that also helps quite commonly. As you can see in this picture, here, this depressed fragment, when it was locked from the lateral screw, did not remain affected. So this is my own case. Here I found a depression, though intraoperatively it was fine. And then changing the screw direction from medial to lateral, so this keeps it elevating further. So this I found quite interesting. I would like opinion on this also. So this is one difficult depression where multiple fragments are there and the whole thing has caved in, not as one fragment. Then we can have a meniscus lifting approach, use a meniscal lifting approach, tie the meniscus with a couple of sutures. These are the fragments. There are multiple. This has gone inside. So you have to exactly look into the joint and then elevate. And this you can see from the lateral side. Have a small distractor across the joint, pull the leg, and then you can put it back into position. with wrapped screws and plate, you can really elevate and fix that very nicely. This typical fracture, if you pull it, it doesn't reduce well into position. So dura elevator, small arthrotomy, and getting that flip back into the joint helps. This is an interesting topsy-turvy fragment. This is completely, the articular surface is down, as you can see from here. So this would require opening the joint and then turning the fragment and then fixing it appropriately. Understanding the depression. So here it looks subtle, though you can make out that this is the density. So this we must not miss on a C-arm, and the effect of cine loop, as you can see, I'll just rotate it fast. So you can appreciate the depression, what is being elevated. So get this effect. Once you get this effect, and you can see now the fragment is elevated nicely. And after the fixation, that gets an absolute perfect restoration of the articular surface. Here, our wrapped screw should support that depressed fragment. At times, you have to place your plate accordingly, bit more posteriorly, so that the anterior end goes more anteriorly. Holding the reduction is another important thing. So in this depression, so here, 2.5 mm K-wire or 3 mm K-wire, 3 K-wire in a row, getting it up elevated and then fixing, avoiding the intersusception. This intersusception always leads to varus. So this has to be avoided. So getting it back, elevating with punch, holding, reducing the condylar width, putting the fragment back into position, holding with the subchondral K-wires, multiple of them, so that the reduction is held well. Condylar width is now compressed. I like to use this clamp, a specially made clamp, which either with a washer in the collinear or with bullet points, or this clamp I like to use quite often. So it has a plate attached itself to the clamp itself. So this part doesn't bury into the joint. And I also like to use this ohm clamp devised by my OT assistant, which holds the clamp, the condyles into position nicely. This is how the plate clamps. So you can attach a small 1.5 K wire, compress. So this gets the condylar width back into position without fragmenting the fragments. Pay attention to the raft plate which you would like to use. So somewhat more posterior if it goes, then this part goes more anterior. If it is putting a bit more anterior, this part goes horizontally. A well-molded plate really gives a good effect in holding these fragments. So how I begin a case, in short, aspirate the knee. If it is quite tense, I like to aspirate by 16-gauge needle. So whenever there is a hematoma, that gets out. Otherwise, the field gets all bloody with the hematoma which is pouring out. 5-incision technique. So this is usually the 5-incision window, a medial MIPPO, a lateral bicondylar fracture, and a small fragment for elevation of the punch, and laterally and medially, again, a MIPPO incision. So these are the 5 incisions usually needed for bicondylar depressed fragments. Subcutaneous tunnels are made, clamps holding the reduction, articular plateau going back into position, varus is reduced, and then fixing the raft plate. So this is intraoperatively when we hold. So we reduce, hold into position, and then fix appropriately. This, when articular surface is shattered, multiple subchondral screw hold really gives a good holding after the articular surface. So this is the sequence of application of screws in a bicondylar fracture. At the end, once the fixation is achieved, you test the full range of movement. Friends, our patient usually desire good range of motion, pain-free, good function. And even after removal of all metal, our bones should be surviving the whole insult of injury as well as the surgical exposure. That what would make a tibial condyle result really good. And the patients are then happy with a full range of movement. In nutshell, improve your armamentarium, reduce the operating time, possibly use 2 drills and multiple chucks. Use essentially a collet to hold K-wire so that you can rapidly put those thing into position. Elevate the plateau, which really elevates the mood of the whole theater. Thank you. Thank you very much.